The Majestic Princess is about to leave Sydney bound for Melbourne after unloading more than 800 passengers infected with COVID. It's Australia's largest cruise ship outbreak since the infamous Ruby Princess debacle, prompting authorities to issue their highest alert level.
As the sun rose, the Majestic Princess pulled into Sydney Harbour, packed with around 4,000 passengers and crew.
It was good to get off.
It feels good.
Waving as they docked in Circular Quay, more than 800 people on board, COVID positive.
I believe there's a number that has been shared in the media.
So can I just confirm that's around the 800 mark?
That is correct.
The president of Carnival Australia confirming they became aware of elevated cases halfway through the ship's 12-day voyage around New Zealand.
We always knew that there was a risk that at some point we were going to see a surge in community transmission and that we would then see that on the ship.
Shutting down any suggestion this is the Ruby Princess Round 2, despite it being the largest outbreak on a ship in Australian waters since.
That was March 2020. We are now in November 2022. That is nearly 3 years ago. And since then, we as a community have learnt a lot.
There's regular protocols in place that have arisen out of the Ruby Princess.
All passengers were tested with positive cases, told to isolate in their cabins for at least 5 days.
Well, we had to wear masks at all times and wash our hands.
And it did get noticeable that there were fewer people around.
Being elderly, our expectations weren't great.
I went 3 years without the COVID, and then you come with that and there's 800 people got it there.
According to the cruise operator, all passengers disembarking the ship have undergone a rapid antigen test in the past 24 hours. And for those who tested positive to the disease, other arrangements have been made to limit the spread in the community.
So far, they're still up there. They're waiting for their breakfast.
We had to sign paperwork. We got new RAT tests given to us.
COVID positive cases exited from a separate door. From there, though, they're free to mingle with the crowds. They were only advised to avoid public transport.
Everyone's in the same boat because they cancelled all the private vehicles that we had ordered.
In the past week, there have been more than 50,000 new cases across Australia. That's almost 8,000 a day, double the week before. And that's just the reported infections.
It's the way of the world now.
And Keziah Dawn is live at Sydney's International Cruise Terminal for us this evening. Keziah, the ship will leave again soon.
Charlotte, we've just been told that the Majestic Princess will depart here at 7:30 tonight, bound for Melbourne, its first stop on an 8-day voyage that travels around Tasmania. Now, Princess Cruises have reassured us that the vessel has been thoroughly cleaned. Each room has been sanitised in line with the current guidelines and protocols for cruise ships just like this. It's also been restocked, ready to welcome its new passengers. The current outbreak really doing little to scare off eager cruise goers. We're told more than 3,000 passengers will board here this evening, and you can probably see a lot of them behind me getting ready to get on board. Now, Princess Cruises are doing everything they can to work with the appropriate health authorities to ensure the safety of the crew, the passengers, and of course the community as well. But they are telling us a lot of this also depends on the passengers doing the right thing. Charlotte?
Thanks for the update, Keziah.